All right, welcome everybody to A2PC. So we just finished sections 7.3 and 7.4. I guess I can add those in here right now to my impromptu title page for this video. And a really cool thing about this is we learned a process that was very much an algorithm. And we kind of said this was very similar to when we did synthetic division way back in chapter 2. One of the cool things about this one in particular is that the structure of a matrix that we use to solve three-variable systems using the Gauss-Jordan elimination method, it was something that it very much arranged our numbers into rows and columns, just like a spreadsheet. And so what I'm going to take you through today is a nice little little project that shows how you can program a spreadsheet software. So you could do this in Google Drive. You could do this in Microsoft Excel. And the one that I'm going to be using is the open source version of Excel or the Microsoft Office suite called LibreOffice. Any of these will have all the functions that we need to make a nice little project file here. So Google Drive would probably be your best bet, just because it kind of follows you everywhere. You have it saved and it's yours forever. But either of these two other options work just as well. All right, and so we're going to be using, we're going to be programming together using this as a guide. We kind of need a problem to start with, and then we're going to program in the steps as we have the numbers there to work with. So this is right off of our 7.3 worksheet. It's problem number one. And so here is our three variable system. And then we already know what the answer is because the key was provided to that one. And so the intention of the worksheet was that you solve algebraically. Well, we've already learned we kind of casually called it the Hitman method. And then we converted this system into a matrix and then went through our calculations using just the numbers. And that's what the spreadsheet will do for us in just a second. But if you imagine, we want to be able to type in any number that we want for our coefficients. We want this to be able to solve any system, not just this one that's right in front of us. And as you may have seen going through your homework exercises, certain problems, you're like, oh, I can simplify this top equation right away. So I'm going to go ahead and simplify the top row, divide everything by two. You know, we're allowed to do little shortcuts when we do the work by hand. But in making this program, we want it to work every single time, even when we're not allowed to simplify. So every time we carry out an elimination step, we're going to imagine that we're trying to eliminate like the X's in this example that I just kind of casually started. So if my Hitman is this 7 and I want it to wipe out this 3 underneath, I can't really do a whole lot. I have to adjust both the Hitman and its target, and then I need to subtract them, right? Or I need to make one of my adjustments negative. So I would need to multiply this by 3 and this one by 7 and then subtract the 2. So that's going to be kind of the logic that we use to set this up, because this type of adjust the Hitman, adjust the target, and then subtract them, that will work no matter what numbers we have inside. We will get the cancellation to happen. All right, so without further ado, I'm going to go ahead and pull up my spreadsheet. Now, I've enlarged the cells and everything just so that you can read the numbers more easily on a video. But if you give me a second to set my tablet aside and slide the keyboard out here. We'll get this thing underway. So the first thing we're going to do is set up some, as we did the Hitman method, what we had were a bunch of matrices where it's like, okay, here's the one that we have initially, and then here's the one where the first Hitman has done his job, and then so on and so forth. So we're going to go ahead and set up some of those right now. So just off to the side, I'm in cell A2 right now. I'm just going to say entry. And then right next to that, I'm going to select, just click and drag until I have a 3x4 rectangle set up where there's 4 columns and 3 rows, just like where the numbers, the coefficients and solutions were showing up in our system. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a border around all of those. And where's my border feature? I should have looked this one up. Should definitely be a formatting option that I have here, but markers. Okay, sorry, I'm zoomed in a whole lot so that that option wasn't showing up on my menu. I had to go off to the side. So just put a block border around all of those just so you know, hey, this is where the entry matrix goes. Okay, and then I'm gonna leave an empty row, and then the next one down, I'm gonna just gonna put first, because this will be the matrix after the first man hitman has acted. And again, I'll select another 3x4 section, and I'll put borders on that. We'll skip a row, and you've probably guessed what's gonna happen next. The second hitman will act, and so we'll make another selection, put borders around that. And then I'll scroll down a little ways. We need a matrix after the third hitman has acted. And then down here, this will be our final matrix after all three hitmen have acted. So you probably noticed in our homework that occasionally we'd have not ones like we want to see, but different numbers. So the final one will simplify everything along the way. And that's where we'll see our final solution show up. Okay. So that's just kind of the setup work. I'm going to just give you a moment right now and clearly state that if you want to pause the video at any time, obviously you're welcome to do so. We're going to be typing some formulas into the formula bar up here and stuff. So if you don't catch anything that I'm typing, there's a lot of repetition. So I'll kind of pick up the pace as we go along. But if you ever need to go back and check anything, you're welcome to do so, obviously. All right, so the one that we're going to do together, just as an example, so we can all follow along with the same numbers, across the top row, we've got -2, and I'm just going to hit the right arrow key to move over to the next cell, then another -2, and then a -6, and lastly, a -4. And again, mine are set up so that they're kind of bold-faced and structured in a way that the numbers are all spaced out. That's just for the video. You can do all of that kind of beautification stuff afterwards. We're focused on the numbers for right now. Next row is a 4x, then a -3y, and then a 1z equal to -7. All right, and then the final row is a -5, +2, 1 for my z, and then that equals 15. Okay. All right, and again, just for the sake of the video being a little bit easier, I'm going to scoot those into the center of their cells, but again, please don't feel like you need to do that stuff right away. You want to make the thing work, then you can make it pretty. Okay, so the next matrix that we're going to fill in is going to be using this one as a guide, the one up above. So this cell in row 1, column 1 is going to be my first hitman, so I'm just going to highlight that, and I can take that away later, I'm sure I will. But then we move to our next matrix and say, okay, in my next matrix, the hitman's row is not going to change. So what I want to do is I want this row to exactly copy whatever the user types in up above. So the user is only going to enter numbers here and then scroll down and find the answer. So the way to do that in Excel or LibreOffice or in Google Sheets is you just hit an equal sign, and then you can put in any type of formula, or I just want it to equal, then I'll just click on this hitman cell from the matrix up above. And you can see it fills in. This cell is going to equal whatever is in cell B2. And then I'll hit enter. And look at that, it's a -2. Now the cool thing about this formula is, if you'll notice in the bottom right-hand corner, and regardless of what program you're in, if you hover your mouse over that, it turns to like a little cross. If you click and drag, it'll slide the formula to go along with it. And so you'll notice that it has perfectly copied the first row from up above. It replicated that formula to do equals C2 and then D2 and then E2. So that's pretty nice. That's our kind of way of saying the hitman's row doesn't change. All right, now let's talk about how we're going to get this entry, because this is where we should see a zero. This is where we do that type of adjustment where the hitman gets multiplied by the target and the target gets multiplied by the hitman and we subtract the two. And that's just because that's the way to make this program work for any matrix with any coefficients. All right, so in this cell, I'm going to hit equals, and then it's whatever's in the current location up above. So here I'm in row 2, column 1. I'm going to click on that cell from the last matrix. Times, you have to put an asterisk here, the hitman, there's our adjustment, minus the hitman, times the target. And we hit enter, we get a zero. Now remember, everything in this target row is going to get multiplied by negative 2. So everything down here gets multiplied by the hitman, and everything up here gets adjusted by the target. So as we fill these in, the next cell equals whatever I had previously, adjusted times the hitman, minus whatever else is in that part of that addition or subtraction, adjusted by the one below, the front entry of the target. Enter. So here I get a 14. Next one, we'll do the same thing. Equals current cell times hitman minus one above times front of the target. Enter. I get a 22. Equals current cell times hitman minus up above times the front of that row. I just call that the target. Enter. I get a 30. All right. And now we're just going to do the same thing with the bottom row. Here, the bottom row is going to be adjusted times the hitman times negative 2 for everything down there. And I'm going to subtract the hitman's row multiplied by whatever's out in front of that target. So first entry equals current cell times hitman. There's our adjustment. Minus hitman times current cell for that one. And you can see it makes those zeros perfectly. We should be seeing zeros there. I should certainly hope. Equals current cell times hitman minus one above times target. Here again, negative 14. Equals current cell times hitman minus one above times target. Equals current cell times hitman, that's the adjustment, minus the one that will combine, times target. And so you may just want to quickly pause and double check that all your numbers are coming back the same as mine here. Since we should be doing the same example together, everything should be matching up pretty nicely. But this would be a good chance to go back and look and see if you're getting the same results. Okay, we'll move on. Now, in this matrix that I've just filled in, our next hitman, we've got the zeros where we want them in column 1. Now it's time to have the second hitman do his work in column 2. That's this 14. So I'm going to highlight that cell because it's the hitman. And then now it's the middle row, right? That's where the hitman is now. That's the one that doesn't change. So equals, I'm in second, the one that I've labeled as second. And I'm going to equal the second row of the one up above. Enter. Let's do our click and drag trick. So 0, 14, 22, and 30 all replicate perfectly. And we certainly don't want to be typing anything in as like a raw number. We always want to be referring to what's up above, because remember, as the user, we only want to type things into the first matrix and have the calculator always refer back to that somehow as it moves its way down. All right, so now as I fill in, because my hitman is this 14 in row 2 now, now my goal is to get zeros up above and underneath that. So I'm going to start here. I have to fill in a new top row. And so that's going to equal the current cell times that hitman, that's the adjustment now, minus what's up above times target row entry, negative 28, equals current cell times hitman minus hitman times current cell. That's easy enough. That's where we get the zero. Equals current cell times hitman minus one below, I guess in this case, times one. I also refer to this as complete the rectangle. You'll notice when we do current cell times hitman, we kind of form a diagonal. It's going to be that product minus the product going the other way that kind of completes a little rectangle. So that's kind of a nice way to remember it. So it equals current cell times hitman minus, and then this times this to complete the rectangle. And that's just a way of describing the pattern. All right, now we're moving down to row 3. Equals current cell times hitman minus. Let's complete the rectangle. Next one equals, and I'm not going to keep saying this over and over again, don't worry. Current cell times hitman minus. but it almost becomes like a mantra. Equals current cell times hitman minus complete the rectangle. I should see, I think it's a 140, negative 140. Good. Equals current cell times hitman minus complete the rectangle. And all that keeps doing when you complete the rectangle is doing the adjustment of adjust this row by the hitman, adjust the other row by the target, and combine them. All right, and I know for a fact that this is what we should be seeing in the last row, because I know that I should get something that simplifies to a 1 and a 2, and that's what I've got here so far. So that's, we're in good shape. Also notice that some of these numbers are getting outrageous, and that's totally fine. Usually when we do the hitman method, we're able to simplify along the way, but remember, we are programming this to work in even the nastiest cases. So you could kind of, I guess, call it taking the scenic route. But if the numbers get nasty, that's totally fine. We're going to simplify it all back down at the very end. This will happen a lot of times just because of the way that we're writing this to work for any situation. All right, so our second hitman has acted. When we move down to the next one, now it's the entry in row 3 that will be our hitman. So it's that row that will not change. So equals, we'll do copy that row 3 from up above, the hitman's row. All right, let's enter the first one here. Equals current cell times hitman minus complete the rectangle. Okay, that's pretty outrageous. That's okay though. Equals current cell times hitman minus complete the rectangle. And we should see a 0, right? After that second hitman did his job. Current cell times hitman minus complete the rectangle. That one should be a 0. That's the hitman. Equals current cell times hitman minus complete the rectangle. Oh boy, big. That's okay. Equals current cell times hitman minus complete the rectangle. Equals current cell times hitman minus complete the rectangle. Oops, sorry, the one down here. Equals current cell times hitman minus complete the rectangle. Final entry here, equals current cell times hitman minus complete the rectangle. All right, and so you can see we've got all of our hitmen to do their jobs perfectly. We've got the diagonal of numbers going top left to bottom right in the square part of the matrix with surrounded by zeros. And then these numbers, just because of all the adjustments that we've made along the way, have gotten kind of outrageous, and that's perfectly fine. Again, if these numbers blow up, that's just kind of a byproduct. Our final result is going to equal, like in the first row, I've got 3,920x equals negative 117,000. I just want to divide both sides of the equation that this represents by this number, the 3,920. So I'm going to equal, and this is going to seem weird, this cell divided by itself. And we're not going to hit enter because we want the whole row. Everything in that row gets divided by this 3,920. And I certainly don't want to type them in each time. So we talked about every time we did the hitman's row doesn't change, we said, oh, you can do that little drag the corner thing and it'll copy the formula. Well, I always want to be dividing by this cell. I don't want to divide by this one next and then divide by this one and then divide by this one. So I want the denominator to always stay B14. I always want that to be this cell that it's dividing. And so to make that do that, your spreadsheet, you just need to put a dollar sign in front of the column number. And all that dollar sign does is it fixes, that's the coding to fix that cell as you drag. The formula will always stay in that column. And so you can see as I drag, now we get 100-3. And you'll notice that if I click on the cells to look at the formula in the formula bar, notice how it has stayed as dividing by B14, even though I dragged that formula along. Okay, let's do the next row. So here, I want to take this entry. Okay, so I'm going to do equals my first entry in row 2 divided by, and then I'm going to put a dollar sign, and now we're dividing everything in that row by row 2, column 2, that this negative 1960. And we'll hit enter. And now when I replicate that, everything in this row is being divided by C15. Okay, and lastly, we want everything in this row to be exactly what it was, except we're going to divide it all by whatever this entry was. So we'll put a dollar sign so we can drag that safely. It's D16. We'll go ahead and hit enter. Go back to that cell and drag the corner. And look at that. There's our negative 3, negative 1, 2, which we knew the solution should have been. Now, there's some other really cool things that we could do with the output. And I'm going to show you one right now. So over here off to the right, I'm going to merge a few cells together. So I'm going to click on maybe these cells over here. It doesn't really matter where, but it'd be nice if I could type in my entry and see the answer right off to the side. So I'm going to merge those cells together, and I'm just going to type the word solution. And then right underneath, I'm going to merge those cells together as well. And I'm going to put a little border around that. Okay, so in this place, I'm going to do something called concatenating. And so I'm going to make a string that will output an ordered triple of whatever solutions I get. So I'm going to put in equals, but then I'm going to put quotation marks because I want this cell to have some text along with the numbers for my answer. So in quotations, I'm going to put an opening parenthesis and then quotations again. So it will display that text. And then I'm going to do Shift-7. It's called an ampersand. But it's the and symbol. And then I'm going to scroll down and grab my first entry. And you can see in the formula bar, it has the parentheses, and it will put E18, whatever number that may be. And, so we'll do another one, parentheses, because I want some more text, comma, space. Sorry, I think I said parentheses, quotes. Quotes, comma, space, quotes. And let's have it do the Y value that we got now. So I'll go down and click on that cell, and you can see it just adds that right into the formula. And quote, comma, space, quote, and then we'll grab, it's E20, but our last solution, our Z coordinate, and quote, closing parenthesis, quote. And when I hit enter, it just puts all three of those answers into a nice little ordered triple. All right, so now would be a good time to save. So we'll go ahead and save this one. I'll just save it as Gauss with two S's, Gauss-Jordan. Okay, and the program's working, you're done. And really you didn't even have to do this last little step. That's kind of a neat little programming trick because, I mean, you're getting the answer down here right away, which is pretty cool. But on our worksheet, let's just test this program and make sure that it works because problem 3 also had a solution. So hopefully when I type in all of the entries, I should see negative 5, negative 1, 1 show up as a solution. Okay, so in our entries, we're just going to type over what we had before. I'm going to get rid of that highlighting that I had earlier so it's a nice clean entry screen. All right, so in the next one, we got a 1, 4, 6, negative 3, and then a negative 1, negative 5, negative 3, and a 7. And you probably see some really weird numbers showing up here. That's totally fine. You may even see some errors or things show up along the way as you enter in new data. But negative 4, 2, 2, the program's working just fine in the background, 20, and there's our negative 5, negative 1, 1. That is awesome. So this is a really, really neat way to check. It's almost like doing RREF in our calculator because we are doing RREF, but we're just, we've programmed all the steps along the way. Some other things that I think might be helpful to you, anytime that I make a spreadsheet or something like that, I like to add shading around, like some gray shading around the outside. You know, anytime there's something that you don't want to be, you know, anybody using this, you don't want to become confused. Where do I type stuff? What can I type over? Because we have a lot of formulas kind of working in the background. And if we have people typing over those, it will type right over the those lovely little formulas that we typed in, and it ruins it. So, and sometimes it's really tough to find the mistake. So this is a nice way of kind of cleaning everything up. And then another thing that I like to do is I only want to have, so maybe I'll make the solution show up as this, I don't know, this lovely pink color. But then any cells that I don't want people to type in, I'll make them a light gray. And so that way I know, hey, this entry, these white boxes, it's safe to type there, but all these other ones are going to be gray. And that way, if you open this up to use this again, now you know, hey, I just type in here and it'll tell me the solution. You know, maybe I don't like that being gray also. I want that to stand out. We'll make that a light yellow. You know, something like that. You can configure that obviously however you want. The program should be working just fine. I hope you found this to be a cool experience. I always think when we learn algorithmic processes, it's really kind of neat to build something like this and see how the process can be used to set up a means of solving a whole number of problems instead of just the one that's in front of you. So I hope you've enjoyed this experience. It's been a lot of fun going through it with you. Thank you for watching.